I can't beat Usain Bolt in a foot race, but this makes it a fair race. It is the Quest Means Business e-scooter. Now, Bolt is also hopping on the craze for electric scooters. He's the co-founder of Bolt Mobility, which is making its international launch in Paris today. But the 8-time Olympic champion has some fierce competition if he is going to outrun those who are already into the market. For instance, Lime has 100-plus different cities, from San Diego to Sydney. University hubs from Georgetown in D.C. to the University of Navarra in Spain. Let's take Bird. Bird also is in 100-plus cities, mainly in North America, Europe, and, of course, in Tel Aviv, also targeting university towns. So the battle is clearly on in the e-scooter race, which is why Anna Stewart has been finding out a little bit more about all of this and been speaking to Usain Bolt in Paris. What have you learned from this investigation?
Well, I have yet to actually challenge him to a race, Richard, but it is a really crowded space, particularly in the US, as you said, but also here in Paris. Lime's made headways in here. We've also got Coupe. And if you go onto one of those apps like City Mapper that integrates your whole transport from A to B, some of those scooter apps are already a part of that. So launching here is a pretty big risk. But I asked Usain Bolt, I asked him, what makes your e-scooter any different to the others? Take a listen.
When I go shopping, we have a storage area for your bags, especially for the ladies, you know what I mean? You have your handbag, you're on the scooter, you don't want to have it on your shoulder, you can place it in the area. Then we have a place for your phone, you know what I mean, just for the GPS, because most people have their phone in their hands and they're listening to the GPS and struggling, so that. And then people who drink coffee, I'm not a coffee person, so I'd have a water, so we have storage area. So we try to think of things that consumers would really like and much easier.
Paris is now talking about banning e-scooters from pavements, sidewalks. In September, in London, you're actually not allowed to ride them on the pavement or on the road. So how is this business going to flourish if no one can ride them?
We're investors in Uber and Hyperloop, Virgin Hyperloop One. So we have a lot of experience and we've learned best practices of how to be able to work with city officials, what works, what doesn't. And we have been really good citizens in the markets that we've launched in, for example, in Fort Lauderdale. We are able to geofence certain areas for spring break. Mm-hmm. When there's great big crowds coming or if there's a festival, we can...
And governments, though, in Europe, are you speaking directly to them, to the French government, to the British government?
Absolutely. We're actually meeting with city officials today to sign an agreement to be good citizens and good actors in France. And that's really, really important for us as a company.
A lot of people I've spoken to, and I've said that I'm meeting you and I'm going to be talking about your e-scooter, say, scooters are for kids, they're not cool.
No, these are grown up, these are solid. We're talking about trying to get from place to place. You know what I mean? Who's thinking about looking cool? We're trying to be efficient. I'm not saying it's not cool, but you're not thinking about that at the moment. I'm trying to get to the doctors right now. I'm trying to get to the traffic jam. I'm not worried about that. This is what I'm focused on. How I'm going to be safe, how I'm going to get there on time. Come on. If I'm doing something, it's going to be cool. Let's just get that out of the way. So.
This is not just a solution in terms of transport, getting A to B. This is also environmentally friendly. And is that something, Usain, you think cities should be taking into account more?
For sure, for sure. If you, throughout the years, that even in London, you guys have so much taxes, congestion taxes, because of these problems, because you're trying to get less cars in the city. So for me, this is a big solution. This is what I'm talking about, that we need to make a difference, to make changes. I'm a part of many charities. I try to do a lot of work with different charities just to help the environment in many ways. And for me to be a part of this company, to be a co-founder of this company, and to help the environment is a big deal for me.
You saying how fast can it go?
Not faster than me, so that's a good sign.
That can still be pretty fast.